here. And a new Transformers trailer came out 2 days ago, trailer 2, and this is my thoughts on it. So much stuff has came in over the past 2 days, Transformers and TV spots. We now see the new girl's backstory, Isabella, how she was teased. People say she throws a girl, fight with a girl, and then she's like, yeah, I fight with a girl. To be honest, seeing her backstory is not that bad, how we hear some of it. And the trailer opens up with these kids now, so apparently Transformers now has multiple kids in the film now. And you know what's also awesome, guys? When we saw the teaser TV spot at the Kids' Choice Awards, we saw baby Dinobots! And oh man, there's one thing I can say. They're so cute! To be honest, they're cute. They may be fake, but I just want one right now. If they were real, I would love to have a baby Dinobot. It's pretty cool to see they're bringing in baby Slug, baby Grimlock, baby Swoop, and yes, I know his name is not Swoop, but I call him that. So anyway, in the trailer, too, we've also been revealed the name of the yellow tank Autobot. It's called, let me just check. Cannabin, I think I said his name wrong, which I thought he was Warpath, but oh well. And we see a lot of Squeak stuff, like, Squeak is in the trailer a lot. And we see some funny moments. What's also interesting about this trailer we see is we finally get to see Crosshair speak, and he has his voice actor from the Fort One. We see B. And so far, this new girl, Isabelle, she looks like she's following maybe the female character that the Transformers movies have been waiting for so long. Like, Tessa and Harley and Michaela were okay, but they were useless in the movies. They were mostly used as just to get guys to see them because they're hot, I would say. That was the only reason. This female character looks like they're actually going to do it right. Where she's not going to be annoying, she's scared, she's actually going to fight and do something with the Autobots and like help them like Cage does. I think they're actually going to do the female lead right. But she's a bit stupid in the trailer because when Squeaks is being held by Megatron like we see in the trailer, and I'll get a minute about that. She says, put him down. You think I'm afraid of you? And she's walking towards, like how many Decepticons are in that trailer? Let's see. Onslaught, One Eye, and Mohawk, I think that's what they call him. She's kinda insane going there. You know, it's also great. We now know what sets off that explosion. Cade Yeager sets off a bomb, which causes him to explode. I remember in the first chair we were wondering, what is that? Was there an Autobot in there fighting? So now we finally know. Cade sets off a bomb. That's why he's running. You know what's also something about it? People thought that it was Onslaught fighting Megatron. Megatron getting his title back as Decepticon leader. That's not that bad, but it's a weird series. So anyway, Cade starts yelling at her, saying, I'm not letting you go with me. And also, there's something in the trailer that they might have spoiled for the movie. Optimus gets his blue eyes back and turns back good. Whatever Cade we saw get in the Super Bowl, I mean, on his chest. Like, did he get the Energon out? The Dark Energon? And it's Dark Energon? Or did Cade, like, get the Matrix out, and that caused him to cure? But whatever he did, looks like it helped cure Optimus. It's kind of strange, though, how that works. And so anyway, when in that part, we see Optimus getting punched in the face by Night Robots. Here's my theory that everyone else keeps saying. maybe when Lockdown died, the knights on Lockdown's ship awoken. That could be something. It's not a bad theory, to be honest. Anyway, halfway through the trailer, we see Bumblebee getting his melt repaired by Isabella. To be honest, that's something great that they're also doing. A female character that can fix Autobots, and looks like she could fix Bumblebee's voice. Like, man, for a 17-year-old in a Transformers movie can fix an Autobot voice, that's just awesome. And learning some of her backstory, how she was a normal kid, went to normal school, got teased a lot, it looks pretty interesting how they're going to give a good human backstory. So, moving on. Trailer, we see a lot of action, like we did in the first one, some old clips, but some new clips. Like, we see that the soldiers fighting on some grass in London, I think, and they take down a ship, which is interesting. Like, we see some pretty good action. And we see Lennox in a helicopter. In the part in the trailer, we see those guys getting floated up in the air. I don't know what that is still. Like, is it Unicron? Like, or is it anti-gravity thing? Or is it, like, Lockdown ship where it would pick up stuff? Like, I don't even know. But last time Lockdown ship was, it was just metal. Plus, we've learned a lot of stuff over the Super Bowl trailer. Like, we found out who said, "Do you seek redemption, Optimus Prime?" It's Quintessa, whatever her name is, I might have said it wrong, I don't care. People thought it was Soulless Prime. Like, I kind of agree too, I thought that was too. And what I forgot to mention, I deleted my Super Bowl, my trailer, my thoughts, because... it's because, I felt like it was too late. Like, it wouldn't make sense talking about it after I came back to YouTube. But I'm going to talk about some of the stuff we did see. We did see something attacking the moon. And I don't know if it's Unicron, like I said, the Quintessons, their planet, the creators, or what we want to call them, or Cybertron. But there's something that made me kind of upset seeing that scene, is the art game destroyed, because I'm a big fan of Transformers 3. To me, like, 3 was my favorite out of all of them. But hopefully it's still going to be on the moon. There's one thing also I gotta say. If the moon's destroyed, Earth is doomed. Alright, moving on back to the regular trailer. And the some spots we've seen in the Kids' Choice Award. Hound's back, better than ever, still smoking. And they have a sing from Prime, if you don't understand. In Prime, the Easter egg is a girl sitting on his shoulder on Bulkhead. Same thing happens in Transformers the last night. Well, I also gotta mention, they're really sticking to this night scene pretty well. Since a lot of robots like Megatron and other people have hammers, swords, and some humans will have swords and stuff. It's kinda cool how they're really sticking to this night scene. Also, what's back in the trailer is these ships. Like, Lockdown's ship is back. Like I said, the knights that are the robots could be controlling it. And some good music is in that trailer. Really good music. We kind of get some also closer looks in that scene, Caden, that one girl is running on, or the planet, wherever it is. We'll find out in the movie. We also see barricades added again with Bumblebee in the car mode, and barricades just looks awesome. Like, seriously awesome. But I have to say the head is way better with his normal form. We also see Cade and the girl, which we did originally see in one of the pictures that they posted. Like, Cade with that like flare. And I think they're in like a knight thing, like full knight weapons, knight armor for Autobots and Decepticons. Or the knights. I do see stuff interesting. Also, we see someone getting strolled through a window. And we see that, like, character that I don't know his name, the African American, not Robert Epps, which we do know that he is back, which we finally know. We see his voice. Like, a lot of action scenes we see, a lot. Like, Hound fighting with the alongside the humans and some, like, Sing, I think it's part of Cybertron. But in the trailer, we keep seeing this, like, plant-like ship. Like, is it the creators bringing their planet down or, like, whatever they're doing? And there's a lot of questions I have to say about this. Like, is Optimus turning good again after what Kate did? I don't know. Like, it looks epic, it looks so good. Like, I'm hyped. Like, I'm really hyped for this movie. Like, to be honest, I'm hyped. Like, I can't wait to see baby Dinobots. This new girl in action, Isabelle. Hopefully she's good. Like, I know she was in a Nickelodeon show. Something's 100 things to do for her. I just can't wait to see what she's doing in an action movie like this. Like, hopefully they do her character right. Like, not annoying. Not insane, not stupid. Hopefully a good character. It's great to see more trailer pics and stuff of Robert Epps and Lennox, because they're good characters. And that's pretty much all I would have to say most of the time. It is a 2-minute trailer, but I'm going to talk about some of the stuff, quotes. There is a good quote that had me kind of laughing. Well, not laughing, but I think it was a good quote. Don't expect any bedtime stories, Crosshair says.
Hey, bro.
Let's go, Isba. Robert Epps' quote. And, like, she calls Squeaks my boyfriend when getting mad at this one boy with glasses. Like, really? Like, do you really? She's like, really? Do you really think I have a robot boyfriend? I have to admit, that was kind of funny and humorous. And we see her, she really is emotional when it comes to Autobots that die, like Canopy. Like, I hope Canopy's not dying, because it would be nice if she can get some voices, some screen time. But overall, nobody's perfect. But I think it would be a waste of character and stuff. I like how Squeaks can also use a gun. Let's see what else I can talk about. What? A few explosions I see in the movie. Like, it's a Michael Bay movie. And Lockdown Ship is back. I don't know how it's back, but it could be the Knights Awaken theory, everyone says. Parachuting is in the new Transformers movie, which is also awesome. And last thing I gotta say is the funny scene at the end is Grimlock eating some car, like, and he's like eating it, and oil comes out of his mouth and nose. Kate's like, "What is that in your mouth? Drop it right now." He's like treating him like he's a pet. And I'm surprised Grimlock would listen. If this was G1 Grimlock, he would be like, "Me, Grimlock, don't listen to human." But he listened to humans in G1. It's kind of funny how he gets yelled at by Cade. Like, there's some questions I do have to say. Where are the other Dinobots? Like, the big ones. Like, where are they? Hopefully in the trailers we find out more. Hot Rod really hasn't been getting any stuff lately. I think we're most likely going to be getting a trailer for Hot Rod soon for Trailer 3, but that's pretty much it, I have to say. Like, I'll be, like, making more, like, thoughts on Trailer 3, if there is going to be a Trailer 3, or some TV spots, or basically anything. And that's pretty much it, what I like to say again. So anyway, subscribe, like, leave a comment. And one last thing about Grimlock being yelled at. What? No. He says, "Go back to your hole and think about what you've done." That's just funny.
a big giant robot getting yelled at by a human, and this is a tough Grimlock. Alright, I'm out, enjoy the rest of the gameplay.